Hello, and welcome to this video on managing NFS storage in Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. In this video, we will introduce basic NFS storage concepts, list the requirements for using NFS storage with Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager, demonstrate the steps for adding NFS storage, and explore the storage domain directory structure on a KVM host. Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager uses storage domains to hold the resources used by virtual machines. These virtual machine resources include disk images, ISO files, templates, and snapshots. Storage domains are defined by the storage interfaces associated with the particular storage types. One supported storage type is file-based storage like NFS or Network File System or other POSIX-compliant file systems. On these file-based storage domains, all virtual machine resources are implemented as files. Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager also supports block-based storage types like iSCSI or Internet Small Computer System Interface and FCP or Fiber Channel Protocol storage. In these block-based storage domains, virtual machine resources are implemented as logical volumes. You can also use locally attached storage for storage domains. Resources stored on locally attached disks are available to the host to which they are attached. It's important to remember that if a host is attached to local storage, it gets placed into its own private cluster, and a host can only belong to one cluster. This means migration functions are not possible for this host, as it cannot be associated with any other hosts. One important note to mention is that you cannot initialize a data center without an activated storage domain attached to it. Remember, to be able to create and maintain storage domains, you should be familiar with the supported storage technologies, including the storage products that use them. Before creating an NFS storage domain, both the KVM host and the NFS server must be configured. On the KVM host, verify that its installation created the VDSM user in the /etc/password file. The VDSM user has a user ID of 36. In the /etc/group file, ensure the KVM group exists with the group ID of 36. The NFS server needs to be accessible to both the manager and the KVM hosts. The storage domain needs a place to store its resources, so you need to create a directory on the NFS server. This directory needs to be owned by the VDSM user and KVM group. This is done by running the ls-l command on the new directory and verifying the correct user and group permissions. You also need to make the correct entry in the /etc/exports file. The formatting of these entries is essential. The command output on the slide illustrates the correct format. Identifying your path to the shared directory and the items shown inside the parentheses are the entries you need to include. Finally, you need to export this directory. Okay, so now let's use the administration portal to create an NFS storage domain. After logging in, I'm taken to the dashboard. The environment contains three KVM hosts and one active storage domain. I click the Data Storage Domains link at the top of the page. The Storage Domains page displays. The only active storage domain listed is for iSCSI block storage. To create and attach a new storage domain, click the New Domain button. In the New Domain dialog window from the configuration options on the left, I first click the Data Center dropdown and select the data center name to which we will attach this storage domain. We can choose any of the data centers available. For this demonstration, I will attach it to the default data center. The second option is the domain function. Clicking its dropdown, we have three choices: data, ISO, and export. Here we select data, as this new domain will function as a data domain because it will contain the virtual disk files and virtual appliances for all virtual machines and templates. An ISO domain holds the ISO files used by virtual machines to boot and install their operating systems. Export domains are the third option. If I wanted to copy or move images between data centers in my environment, I would store them in an export domain. Clicking the storage type dropdown, we select NFS. The last option is which host to use. The dropdown menu will list the available hosts. Here we will take the displayed host OVS037. The new storage domain requires a name. I will paste in the name nfs-data-domain for this demonstration. In the export path field, we provide the full path using the fully qualified domain name of the directory exported from the NFS server. So for convenience, I paste this into the field. Under this field, there are two expansion buttons for custom connection parameters and advanced parameters. Expanding the custom connection parameters, a message is displayed recommending to keep the default values unchanged. You can set values for the NFS version used, number of retries to attempt, and the length of time before the domain timeouts, as well as additional mount options. Expanding the advanced parameters, we can set warning thresholds on storage capacity. But for this demonstration, we will leave everything default as per the recommendation message, so we click OK. This closes the new domain dialog and refreshes the storage domains list. We now see the new domain with our selected name added to the list. As the storage domain is set up, we can see the cross data center status changing from unattached to locked. The task messages appear at the top showing the status as the domain is added, and soon we see the finished attaching storage domain message. Cross data center status, an icon indicator in the table, now also shows active. With this done, we can now explore the directory structure of our data storage domain. To do this, we can log into any of our KVM hosts in the cluster and see the exported directory mounted on them. So let's have a look at this on a KVM host I've already logged into using SSH. I run the df-h command to list the mounted file systems. For security reasons, some information shown may be blurred out. Identifying the mount point of the exported data directory, we see a file system that begins with the /rhev in the name. To view what the data storage domain contains, we change directory to the mounted file system and use the ls-l command to list the directory contents. The data storage domain is the directory identified by its UUID. We change directory to the UUID directory and list its contents. The data storage domain's directory contains two subdirectories, dom_md and images. Changing into the dom_md directory, we see it contains 6 files. The metadata file is a text file description of the storage domain. The other 5 files are metadata files associated with the domain. Now we change directory to the images directory and list its contents. We see it contains 2 UUID name directories which appear by default. These hold
OVS
store images.
OVS
store images contain the metadata of VMs and disks that reside on data domains. This metadata is used in case of failure when importing or exporting to or from a different data center. In this video, we introduced basic NFS storage concepts, listed the requirements for using NFS storage with Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager, demonstrated the steps for adding NFS storage, and explored the storage domain directory structure on a KVM host. Oracle provides an extensive number of resources which you can use to find out more about this subject and others. You can find documentation on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager at the link shown. There's a comprehensive Oracle Linux curriculum available to support a full range of Linux administration skills for cloud, on-premise, and hybrid users. For more information or to get started on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to cloud.oracle.com. And for more training on Linux on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to the link shown here. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.